first CUNYAC Game of the Week. We're so glad that you are here to join us. I'm John Perez. We just spoke to Ryan Hyland and a few special guests, his two little cousins, who are rooting him on, wearing the throwback John Jay jerseys, which is pretty cool to see. Let's give you the starting lineup for the Lehman Lightning, who come in at 2-2. They'll roll out Will Feldman and Fred Truss in the backcourt, Xavier Boyd, Isaiah Gethers, and Miguel Habush up front. For John Jay, a similar starting lineup, although John Jay will be undermanned, and we'll get to that in a moment. Romello Ford in the backcourt, along with the Sean Epps and Jerome Petty. Up top will be the forwards, Kyle LaGuardia and Doug Levy. John Jay shorthanded because Luciano Cruz Fernandez had been out with the knee injury his last two games. Turns out the diagnosis after an MRI is a torn ACL. His season is over, and who knows what will lie ahead for Cruz Fernandez in the future. He can redshirt, and we'll see if he still has credits to be had. He could play on the team next year. John Jay also without the services of Otis Gaws and Connor Brott as well. Gaws had a stress fracture. He should be good to go for homecoming. At least that's what the initial diagnosis said, although we won't know until we see him out on the floor. And Connor Brott not playing today with an undisclosed injury as well. However, why those injuries are big? Well, John Jay already has the height advantage against Lehman, but this is a John Jay team that does like to play aggressive. They get into foul trouble very quickly. And Hyland will be without the services and the 10 fouls between Otis Gaws and Connor Brott combined. John Jay in their home whites, Lehman in their road blues. As we are set to go here from the doghouse, our officials today, Arnold Saunders, along with Dave Messino and Paul Diaspara. It'll be Levy and Gethers to tip it off, and that should be a fun matchup down low today. As what a season Doug Levy and Isaiah Gethers are both having. Levy ninth in the conference in scoring, and Gethers eighth, and the tip will go for the Bloodhounds. It's Romello Ford to Jerome Petty. Sean Epps, the backdoor cut, and he gets two. Sean Epps now 2 points away from moving to second place all-time in John Jay's scoring list. And here come the Lightning. The Lightning on a two-game winning streak, coming off a 74-65 win over Keystone College in Pennsylvania. As the three is off the mark from Fred Truss, but the putback goes through for Xavier Boyd. And a 2-2 game early on. Levy to Epps. Levy on the wing, screened by LaGuardia. And Levy too strong on the jumper. Ball tapped back out. Petty down low to LaGuardia. And now it's Ford and a reset. John Jay coming off a 16-point win over the Maritime Privateers in Throgs Neck Tuesday night. Sean Epps leading the way with 28 points. The Bloodhounds shooting 51% from the floor. And Kyle LaGuardia will head to the line. As that foul will go on Isaiah Gethers. His first and the team's first. As LaGuardia, the 6'6 sophomore out of Smithtown West, had 12 points and 5 boards in 31 minutes against Maritime Tuesday night. As he knocks down the first free throw. Now 3 of 7 on the year from the charity stripe. Yeah. And 2-for-2 for LaGuardia. This is a Lehman team that has lost a lot from last year. No Andrew Utate, no Milo Mitchell. Petty lets a three fly, cash. Jerome Petty, the 6'4 senior out of Seattle. That's his fifth triple make of the year. Shooting at just over 20% now from downtown. John Jay really wants him to find his shot, and they're very encouraged by that corner three. Feldman to Habush, a three, yes. Miguel Habush, a sophomore out of Uruguay. And that's in his arsenal. He's not afraid to pull up. Had 13 points, 8 boards Monday night against Keystone. Petty, another three, the other side, you betcha. Let the threes rain. Xavier Boyd, the senior from Poughkeepsie. John Jay by two. Levy in the post. Matched up with Geathers. Gets the help. Levy trying to tap it around. And Fred Truss comes away with it. Nifty dribble to get around LaGuardia. Another three. Boyd straight on. Yes. Back-to-back threes made by Xavier Boyd. And a one-point edge for the Lightning on the road. Good crowd on hand in this CUNYAC game of the week. Levy gets the roll. I'd say it's probably about 60-40 Bloodhound fans, as the Lehman crowd always travels well. And not that bad of a commute either. Could just take the two or the one downtown. Epps with the intercept. Boyd was looking inside to Geathers. Here's Levy on the wing. And now it's Ford. Levy loses it momentarily. Has to work around the official Arnold Saunders. And Epps controls up top. Boyd will get the assignment on Epps today with a combination of Geathers in there as well. Active hands by Geathers. But he loses it. Here's Epps. Epps, a two short. Feldman. Not that time. And tipped back out. First miss from Lehman from the field. As Habush comes out of the dust. 4.5 gone by. First half. John Jay leads by one. Lehman has won 6 of the last 7 meetings against the Bloodhounds. Habush's runner doesn't go. Fellow number 33, Doug Levy, comes out of the pack with it as well. Here's four. Throws it up. No, but a foul. And this will lead to a timeout on the floor. Romello Ford will shoot free throws when we return. A 12-11 lead for John Jay at home. 15:06 to go in the first half. You're watching John Jay Men's Basketball on your home for all Bloodhound sports, johnjayathletics.com.
I don't know what happened.
Well, Bloodhound fans, you can check out all of the Bloodhound's updates, articles, and pictures on johnjathletics.com, as well as on Twitter and Instagram at JJAYAthletics. Romello Ford fouled before the media timeout, so he'll shoot two. That foul, the first personal on Fred Truss. Ford, a 5'8 sophomore out of Staten Island, shooting only 35% from the free throw line as he dials in the first one. John Jay head coach Ryan Hyland stating before the year that the Bloodhounds have never had a point guard that can make plays the way that Romello Ford does, at least under the Hyland administration. Three-point lead for John Jay. Boyd misses a three. Habush to the ground along with Petty, and John Jay comes out of it. And a foul underneath. And that's going to go on Geathers. And that is Geathers' second. So a big blow to Lehman early on. Ford on a screen from Levy whips it to Petty in the corner. Now snapped up top to LaGuardia, and now it's Ford. Five to shoot. Ford has to operate. Drives around two defenders. Can't nail the jumper, and Feldman gets it in to Raheem Bakari. It's Habush, Feldman, Truss, along with Boyd and Bakari on the floor for Lehman. Epps, Petty. Petty with a head of steam all the way to the cup. The finger roll is good. 8 points for Jerome Petty. And the lead is five for John Jay. Ford, Levy, LaGuardia round out the John Jay lineup. Rejected by Ashawn Epps. Good defense from me as Santiago Collado will check in for Jerome Petty. As Feldman flips it into Boyd. Habu straight on three. You betcha. Second three made from Habush. He's got eight. John Jay's lead is down to two. Epps, a three. You got it. Ashawn Epps now moves into second place on John Jay's all-time scoring list. And he is now 202 points away from capturing the top spot. Oh, and a 5-point lead for the Bloodhounds as well. Habush to Truss. Tapped up. Boyd. Boyd lets it fly over LaGuardia. It's short. Both teams shooting the ball well. Lehman 4 of 7 from downtown. John Jay, 3 of 4, those two threes, two of those three threes coming from Jerome Petty. And now here's Collado, first-year member on the team. Low pass to Ford, he's beyond the arc. Epps is feeling it, lets it go short. And Habush with the board, flips it up ahead to Boyd. Boyd, Lehman can run the floor. Xavier Boyd. He's got eight. And a 19-16 lead for John Jay. Collado with three, no. And Bakari gets the rebound. Habush, more of an Andrew Utate type for Lehman. Remember Lehman losing players like Utate, and Utate, an all-conference player the last 2 years, also losing Milo Mitchell. But that will lead to our under 12 media timeout. 11:45 to go in the first half. John Jay leads by three. Santiago Collado on the floor for John Jay. Let's get to know the first-year player.
My name is Santiago Collado, and I play for the John Jay men's basketball team, and I'm a freshman. I chose John Jay because it gave me an opportunity to play. My name is Santiago Collado, and I play for the John Jay men's basketball team, and I'm a freshman. I chose John Jay because it gave me an opportunity to play basketball after high school, and I felt like I wouldn't want to go to school without basketball. It's definitely the gym. I see myself either playing overseas or being a cop. Chris, Romello, and Otis. Either me, Jerome, or Otis.
Hi, my name is Janelle Stott-Hodge. I'm the head coach for the women's swim team and 2015 class alumni. I chose to come to John Jay because I was very much so interested.
The league championship is on Thursday, March 7th at 7 p.m. at York College. John Jay finished in second place in 2018. And we look forward to its second championship in program history. And there's the announcement for Sean Epps, who has now moved into second place all-time on John Jay's scoring list. Epps last year joining the 1,000-point club at Brooklyn College on January 3rd, becoming the first Bloodhound since Chris Owens to join the 1,000-point club. And with plenty of games to play in the schedule, Epps with a real opportunity, if all breaks right for him, to not only break the record, but have some padding in there as well. Jordan Aiken in the game, the pass to Levy, and Levy knocks down the jumper from Aiken. As Doug Levy's on the board, and John Jay leads by four. Jaquan Strong also checks in for Lehman. It's Strong, Feldman, Habush with Truss and Angel Nunez. LaGuardia on the block, up top to Collado. He's feeling it. In and out. Strong in third gear. Offensive foul. Jordan Aiken comes in and draws the charge. And the fourth turnover for Lehman. Eric Pujos makes his first appearance of the afternoon, coming in for Kyle LaGuardia. For John Jay, it's Epps, Aiken, Pujos, Collado, and Levy. Jordan Aiken missing the first two games of the year for personal reasons, as the search for John Jay's backup point guard continues. And it's going to be a cluster of Aiken and Collado with the touch of Eric Pujos. All three on the floor right now, as Aiken will operate up top and give way to Collado on the wing. Throwing it to Levy in the post, and Lehman has made an effort to double Levy every time down the floor. Aiken to Epps. Epps catches the tough pass and scores. As Sean Epps continues to get buckets, he's got seven. John Jay's lead is six. Habush thought about it. Good closeout defense from Pujos. Midway through the first half. Feldman up top, Strong with seven, lets it fly, can't get it to go. That ball was halfway down. This is a Lehman team that's shooting 47% from the floor, but how about Doug Levy? He shoots 57% from three, And he knocks down his first one. And a walk. And how about the John Jay bench? Ryan Highland has said that the attitude has changed. And you could see it too in their play. And with the old cliche of playing to win as opposed to playing not to lose, well, John Jay took its lumps against NYU. And since then has played to win as opposed to play to lose. With that ball thrown away, Feldman lays it in. Will Feldman, a 6'1 freshman from the Bronx, coming off a season-high 10.6 rebound performance against Keystone. And he's finally on the board. A timeout called by John Jay. A quick 30-second timeout. 9 minutes, 11 seconds to go in the first half. John Jay leads it 26-19. Bloodhound fans, save the date. Homecoming will take place on Tuesday, December 11th at the Doghouse. The women's team will face off against Sarah Lawrence at 5 p.m., followed by the men facing Bard at 8 p.m. In between games, John Jay will announce its John Jay College Hall of Fame Class of 2019 and introduce the current members of the Hall of Fame. And one lucky fan will have the opportunity to make a half-court shot for $10,000. That's Tuesday, December 11th at the Doghouse. Eric Pujols, a three. You got it. John Jay feeling it from downtown. Now 5 of 9 from beyond the arc. And a 10-point lead. Aiken to Pujols. Pujols a three. Got it. Eric Pujols providing a spark off the bench. Back-to-back three, 6 straight. As Pujols only had 2 points in 3 games played this year. John Jay with its largest lead of 13. Rejected by Levy. Truss loses it. Here's Pujols. It's a 2-on-1. Pujols tries to flip it to Epps. Epps saves it to Collado over Feldman. You got it. Santiago Collado. 8 straight for John Jay. Truss rejected again. Doug Levy. Doug Levy has been a machine so far this year for John Jay. And John Jay cruising to a 15-point lead. Lehman will talk it over. Timeout on the floor. Let's take a look at the rest of the CUNY Athletic Conference last night. Brooklyn beating York at home. Megar Evers also at home in Brooklyn, knocking off Hunter. And CSI defeating CCNY 92 79. John Jay this year picked to finish second in the CUNYAC preseason poll. Lehman picked to finish sixth. Of course, CSI picked to win the conference. The back-to-back defending CUNYAC champions. John Jay with a 15-point lead. And they've been getting it done on all ends. Isaiah Gethers misses the inside shot as Jerome Petty brings it up. It's Aiken, Collado, Petty, LaGuardia, and the red-hot Eric Pujos, who has knocked down back-to-back threes to help balloon John Jay's lead. Aiken lets it fly. John Jay can't miss from downtown. It's contagious. John Jay, 7 of 11 from deep. The last time these two met was in the CUNYAC semifinals last year. Lehman has lost a good amount of its core. John Jay has not, and they haven't forgotten. Remember, John Jay trailed Hunter in the first half of the semifinals. Of the quarterfinals, and then came back to win. Ryan Hyland's second career postseason win, but his first real postseason win, of course, the first postseason game against Mega Rivers, John Jay won via the forfeit. LaGuardia off the window and in. LaGuardia now with 4. John Jay's lead is 20. Here's Raheem Bakari. Gethers lets it go. Off the mark. Rebound Petty. Remember, Gethers picked up those two early fouls, and Steve Shulman forced to throw in Gethers to try and cut the deficit. Levy misses the layup at first. Second chance, no good. And here's Feldman gliding into the front court. Evades Petty and Collado. Throws it into a tight window. LaGuardia for a moment had it, but never really had control, and a blocking foul. Count the basket for Isaiah Gethers. As Aiken will pick up his first personal. Rebella Ford will come in for Aiken. Good spark of energy for Aiken to help the John Jay second team. One shot coming for Gether is a 6'3 sophomore out of the Bronx. Started his career at Monroe College, but only played in 5 games before being injured. He'd only averaged 2.4 points a game in those 5 contests. However, he'll be a focal point for Lehman this season. Ford up top to Collado, straight on 3, no. And Gethers wraps the board. Ninth in the conference in rebounds per game with 7, and he gets the finger roll. Gethers now with 4. Collado to Petty, and the ball movement for John Jay has been exceptional. Petty now with 10. Feldman a 3, no. Bakari jostling with Collado for possession. And it'll stay with Lehman as Levy will come in for Pujos. Also coming in for Lehman, Ethan Lizarraga, a sophomore out of East Elmhurst, but went to high school at Old Tappan in New Jersey. Final 5 minutes to go in the opening half. Habush off the screen. Good defense from Petty, closing the window. Lizarraga to Boyd. Boyd knocked down a few threes a few minutes ago, but has been quiet ever since. And John Jay has done a really good job not making any passes easy for Lehman, as the Lightning have 7 to shoot. into Habush. Catch and shoot. That's a long two off the mark. Gathers the board and a foul on the floor. As the foul's going to go on Kyle LaGuardia. His second. Highland wanted to get Juwan Frazier in to replace LaGuardia. Let's see how aggressive LaGuardia is. About 28 seconds till the next media timeout. As Lehman gets two back. Here's LaGuardia to Levy. Tries to snap a pass underneath to Petty. And now Frazier will come in to relieve LaGuardia and his two fouls. Point lead for John Jay. This is the largest of the contest. As Mo Idrisu comes in for the Lightning. Three ball, corner from Levy, no. And Levy finds his way, getting the long rebound. Pass gets to Petty, thought about it. Now he takes the three, no. And the foul's going to go on Frazier. Under 4 minutes to go in the first half. Here is Lizarraga. Shaded by Ford. Moved up top. Gathers to Boyd. Gets around Frazier. Ball goes out of bounds. This will lead to a timeout on the floor. 3:38 to go in the first half. It's been all John Jay. They lead at 41-25. As hot as the John Jay basketball teams has been, the swimming team has been playing well as well. Let's meet their head coach, Janelle Stott-Hodge.
Hi, my name is Janelle Stott-Hodge. I'm the head coach for the women's swim team and 2015 class alumni. I chose to come to John Jay because I was very much so interested in their forensic psychology program. That was kind of initially what I came here for, and then I fell in love with the sports and everything else that came with it. My favorite part of John Jay, of John Jay and my entire experience with it would be swimming and the pool. The funniest person on the team, I must say, is Nicole. She has a very funny personality. Definitely Nicole. The funnier moments in practice, I want to say dives. Dives are always funny, especially when you belly flop.
When it comes to legends at John Jay, Vince Maiorino is one. Back here at the doghouse, John Jay leading 41-25. On the floor for the Bloodhounds, Romello Ford, Santiago Collado, with Sean Epps, Jerome Petty, and Doug Levy. For Lehman, it's Ethan Lizarraga, along with Xavier Boyd, Isaiah Gathers, Mo Idrisu. Petty, three, yes. Petty, a perfect 3 of 3 from downtown, leading all scorers with 13 and a travel. Miguel Habush, the other Lightning not mentioned before. Ford. Now it's Collado with 3 minutes to go. The fall away, short, leaving the offensive board. And Ford will slow it down. Collado inside. Count it and the foul. Santiago Collado attacking the baseline, getting the bucket and a chance for another one. First trip to the charity stripe for Santiago. And he handles it flawlessly. Coaching staff is still waiting for the breakout game by Santiago Collado. And they feel there's a lot of untapped potential in their young freshman. Gethers can't get it to go. And now it's Epps. Collado from the wing, in and out. Gotta love the confidence from him, though. Lizarraga stops his dribble. Truss, hop step, that's a travel. Twelfth turnover committed by Lehman. John Jay has forced opponents into 19 turnovers per game and has them on a trajectory to eclipse that. Lehman, of course, by that same token, also committing 19 turnovers a game. 22-point lead for John Jay. Here's Pujols to Ford. Fumbles it momentarily. Now it's Petty to Pujols and Epps. Epps off the backboard. That was an uncomfortable shot to begin with. His momentum had him gliding behind the backboard, and that's where his shot went. He actually shot that left-handed. Gethers over Pujols. Count it. Gethers with six. Final minute 05 to go in the first half. Petty and Habouche tries to throw it inside to Levy. And Levy might have been held onto. Or the pass might have been too strong. Either way, it leads to a turnover and then a foul. And the foul's going to go to Jerome Petty. His second. And two upcoming before Truss, a 6'2 senior out of Yonkers, New York, went to Palisades Prep. And he misses the first free throw. One more for Truss. He got it. Coming up at halftime, two episodes of Inside the Doghouse. As we take a look at the legendary career of Vince Maiorino and the emergence of Doug Levy. But the way Jerome Petty's playing today, a potential inside the doghouse for him as well. Final 30 seconds to go, first half. It's been all John Jay. Truss on the wing. And a 3-second violation. As the shot clock turns off, John Jay can play for one. And LaGuardia will check back in. Epps on the wing. Seven to shoot. Now 5 seconds. Gets it to Petty. Petty inside to Levy. They're not going to get a shot off if that ball would have stood in bounds. But now a quick catch and shoot for John Jay. Petty the trigger man. Into the corner, Levy lets it go at the horn. No. And that will do it. John Jay, led by Jerome Petty's 15 points, Doug Levy had 7 points as well as 7 rebounds on a Sean Epps passing Phil Atkinson for second place on John Jay's all-time scoring list in that first half. Halftime here at the Doghouse, 49-28, John Jay. When it comes to legends at John Jay, Vince Maiorino is one of the first people to come to mind. For the last 16 seasons, Maiorino has walked the halls with the bravado of a 14-time MAC champion, 3-time Coach of the Year, and a Robert Ketzner Service Award recipient. With over 40 years of rifle coaching experience, Maiorino says that rifle was love at first sight.
It was quite an experience, and I started to enjoy it. And after that, I just never stopped enjoying it. I loved the coaching part, and I wanted to learn how to do that. And so I started studying for that, and eventually got my coaching credentials. And as I progressed, I coached the junior teams and then some club teams, and eventually moved up to coaching at St. John's. Originally, I came to John Jay to start a pistol program. I'm also a certified pistol instructor as well as a certified rifle instructor and a level 2 small bore coach, international and NRA competitions. So when I came here, in the beginning, I wasn't actually coaching here. I was just teaching pistol and developing another course called Development of Weapons. And after a couple of years here, they asked me to go full-time. I was only here as an adjunct. They asked me to go full-time as a professor and to take over the rifle team. And I decided at that point that I would do that, and that was in 1982, and I've been here as the head coach ever since. Winning is important because it lends status to the program, but in the long run, yes, it's more important to develop good citizens, and I think that that is an important part of the program. I'd have to say that these are some of the finest individuals that I've ever worked with. They're fantastic. A lot of dedication, a lot of hard work. They're all just wonderful young people, and it's been an honor and a privilege to be able to coach them.
The 2018-19 season is a big year for the John Jay Bloodhounds. Picked to finish second in the CUNY Athletic Conference, John Jay has won 3 of its first 4 games and has been led by junior center Doug Levy. In his first 4 games, Levy has averaged 15.5 points a game to go along with his 13 rebounds and 4 blocks per contest. In other words, he's been a machine.
I put a lot of pressure on myself in that regard. I knew freshman year, like after the season, that I struggled a lot. And I think the general consensus was that it was because I was kind of out of shape, a little overweight. So I like to keep myself to a high standard now, at least. And so that was a big part of it. And I was told the offseason was a great time to get in great shape. So I did all I could and had to fight for it, but here I am.
Doug really worked hard and took the criticism and took the coaching that our staff gave to him to heart. We talked to him about getting in better shape and getting stronger and not just slimming down to the point where he can move more freely, but really becoming a presence in the post where he was a mismatch, whether he was on the perimeter or in the post versus a bigger guy or a smaller guy, quicker versus bigger, and obviously bigger versus some of the quicker guys. Doug took it to heart, and all the transformation that he's made is really all credit to him.
He isn't afraid to tell me straight up what I need to work on, and he told me that the biggest thing was to, you know, transform my body into essentially a college athlete body because I didn't have that freshman year. So him holding me accountable definitely helped that process. A common workout was basically morning, just going to the track, getting a good run in, doing a lot of sprints. I also worked for a moving company, so that definitely helped the process too, having like 14-hour days of just straight lifting furniture. But really just being consistent with it, I think that was the biggest thing too. There would be times I remember back in high school where I would just take a lot of days off and do nothing. It was just gotta be consistent, have like a good workout program.
With the 6'8 frame, Levy has always been one of the taller players on the court, but his basketball growth was non-traditional.
It's actually funny. I only played 1 year of high school basketball, realistically. They definitely wanted me down low, just because obviously I was a lot bigger than most kids were back then. But I found myself a better shooter when I was younger, so I actually had to develop my skills inside first before I can go outside again, if that makes sense. But yeah, definitely in high school they saw me as a true five, so I definitely played a lot in the paint.
In his first two seasons, the Bloodhound's record was a combined 23-31, including a 9-game losing streak to start Levy's career. However, Levy now feels all the pieces for a special season are coming together.
Definitely the first 2 years were a big struggle because we always had all these new kids coming in. I remember we had, I think, 9 new kids my first year, and then like 8 new kids the second year. So it's always hard to build that chemistry right away. And we always didn't have like the greatest leadership. But now that, you know, we're all like upperclassmen, like I said, like me, Sean, and Jordan, we definitely try to hold people accountable. And I think that's the biggest thing, because freshmen definitely change the course of it, like a season. You know, you gotta have them engaged the whole time, and the coaches definitely do their best to hold us accountable as well. I think this is the most talented roster we've had by far since I've been here. We've had talent in the past, but a lot of egos have gotten in the way, and I think this year we've got definitely the right mix of talent with the right mindset that, hey, you know, we're not gonna do this on our own. Like, we have 5 people on the court at all times that are gonna help us do what we need to do to win games.
In New York City, there is a place for people that want to be a part of something bigger than themselves, where if you work hard, the possibilities are endless. A place to learn, train, and play. In that order, the City University of New York Athletic Conference. This is where it all comes together. Find your people, be a part of a team, and don't just play the game. Change the game. Champions aren't born, they're built. The City University of New York. Be exceptional.
Halftime here at the Doghouse. I'm joined by assistant coach Dave Munchnick at a 21-point lead. But how contagious is it when not just the regulars are hitting threes, but guys coming off the bench are knocking down shots?
Absolutely, and they're guys that are capable of it. You know, and the two big stats for us, 14 assists on 18 made field goals. That's not something we've had a lot of the first four games. And then forcing 13 turnovers by Lehman, that is something we've had, but we've been able to be really efficient on the offensive end as well.
What is it about the press that's forcing those turnovers? Because it's not that traditional Louisville trap them in the corner. You guys are just making them make mistakes.
Yeah, it starts with Kyle LaGuardia at the top of it. He's so long and athletic, really forces teams to kind of catch the ball on their heels to start. Eshawn Epps, you know, not only is he going to become hopefully the school's all-time leading scorer, I think he is the all-time leading steals guy right now. So he's just really good at reading the passer's eyes. And then we have length, we have athleticism, we have versatility on the back line. Jerome, Doug, Romello played a great first half, really harassing Feldman a little bit. So really it was a complete first half. We got to put 20 more minutes together.
All right, Coach, appreciate the time. That's Dave Munchnick. Second half coming up when we return. Second half starting here at the Doghouse with John Jay leading 49-28, and there's a steal. Kyle LaGuardia can't get the rebound as it goes out of bounds, and it'll stay with John Jay. Well, you heard Dave Munchnick talk about the defense that John Jay has played. Well, John Jay, not just having a great year in the CUNY Athletic Conference so far as they open up conference play, but just how about the way that they've been playing nationally? They're ninth in the nation of 414 teams in steals per game, and their scoring defense is fifth in the nation at allowing just 53.9 points a game. LaGuardia, the turnaround is short. Levy underneath, second chance, and he gets the roll. And here's that vaunted press again. It's not as aggressive as the Rick Pitino Louisville press. And Gethers gets fouled. And I believe that's going to go on Petty. As Gethers hits the free throw. Isaiah Gethers in the first half, 6 points. He knocks down his first two. John Jay still with a 21-point lead. And Romello Ford, who has been in foul trouble the last two games, has kept the fouls down and has done a good job manning the point. And you can see the dish right there to LaGuardia. Epps almost with the steal, and it'll stay with Lehman. Habush, and now Gethers taking on Levy. Levy alters the shot, and Epps rips the board. Ford with a head of steam to Petty, and that pass too far off to Petty's left and took away his momentum to accelerate to the basket. Ford from the elbow now swishes it over to Petty. Epps had some separation, gets a screen from Levy. Levy, wing three, yes. Doug Levy, as you heard in the Inside the Doghouse, saying how he was always a shooter and had to learn to become a big man in high school, and only really playing one full year of high school basketball. But of course, when you're 6'8", you'll get attention from coaches. Highland had been recruiting the island, and Levy starting the pipeline to Smithtown West. Thought about another three, but here's Ford. The southpaw drills it. John Jay, the Rainmakers, shooting 55% from downtown, and the lead is 29. Epps lets it go. You got it. Lehman calls timeout. John Jay is feeling it. A 32-point lead as we have a timeout on the floor. Thank you. Well, Bloodhound fans, all home men's and women's basketball and volleyball games are live streamed and archived on johnjathletics.com/watch. In addition, you can follow the live stats during all home games at johnjathletics.com/livestats. John Jay, 11 of 19 from downtown. That's a 57% clip. John Jay had been 7th in the CUNY Athletic Conference in three-point percentage at 27%. Of course, David Munchnick saying that Pujols and Aiken probably are the best shooters on the team, but they don't get enough playing time, and, you know, just from a natural standpoint, the best shooters, but of course are limited in their other areas, which is why they don't get the minutes that Ford and Epps and the starters get. However, they know that it's always in their back pocket that Aiken can come in and wreck a game. Same thing with Pujols. Jaquan Strong blows the layup. Feldman gets fouled by Ford. That'll be the first personal on Ford. And here's Juwan Frazier. Frazier comes in for Levy. Collado comes in for Epps. Moa Drissel, offensive foul. Juwan Frazier drawing the charge on a lumbering 6'3 freshman, Moa Drissel, who has struggled in his first game of his collegiate career. Collado and Ford. Now LaGuardia on the wing, and Collado mishandles the handoff. And we'll have a media timeout. 15:50 to go in the second half. A 32-point lead for John Jay at home. You're watching the CUNYAC Game of the Week on johnjayathletics.com. Well, Bloodhound fans, the next men's and women's basketball doubleheader will be next year in 2019 when the Bloodhounds host Baruch College on Thursday, January 3rd. The women's game will start at 6 p.m., followed by the men's at 8 p.m. Both games will be live streamed right here on johnjayathletics.com/watch. It has been a shooting exhibition for John Jay in what for many of the returners can see as the revenge game, as Lehman knocked off John Jay in the CUNYAC semifinals last year. That coming after a spirited win in the quarterfinals for the Bloodhounds. In the quarterfinals against Hunter, Lehman would lose in the final to CSI to capture their second straight CUNYAC Conference tournament. Of course, that CSI team picked to repeat this year in the preseason coaches poll. As Jaquan Strong gets to the hard way. Be a third personal on Kyle LaGuardia. John Jay will play at CSI Tuesday night. 7:30 tip. And which could be a possible one of three matchups with the Dolphins this year should they meet in postseason play. The Dolphins will come to the Doghouse on January 23rd. That's a Wednesday night. You can watch that game right here on johnjayathletics.com/watch. Collado, pull away, jumper's good over Habush. John Jay on a 13-3 run, gathers no, collects his own miss. And now it's Feldman. As Feldman tries to slip it underneath. And it's another turnover. 16th turnover that John Jay is forced. And a travel called against Collado. A late whistle by Arnold Saunders. Strong lost it. Here's Feldman. Levy had active hands in there. And then he fouls Strong. And for Levy, that's his first personal. Jaquan Strong, a 5'9 junior out of the Bronx by way of Eagle Academy. Missing the first one. Of course, there are three Eagle Academies. And the one as mentioned. And another one in Queens. I believe another one in Upper Manhattan. Strong hits the second one. Here's Eric Pujols providing a spark off the bench in the first half. Remember, John Jay is shorthanded today. Luciano Cruz Fernandez diagnosed with an ACL tear. And then without Connor Brott and Otis Gaz. Brott and Gaz will injuries, hopefully not as severe as Fernandez. There's Pujols. Defense! Defense! The one thing that Highland can do with a 30-point lead is mix and match lineups. Here's Epps with one, and John Jay didn't know how much time there was as Epps' pass negated a shot clock violation, and Strong gets the bucket. Strong scored the Lightning's last 3 points. Epps in the post. The turnaround. It swirls in. As Sean Epps with 12 points. In 21 minutes of action. Gathers over Levy. Off the mark. Well, we mentioned how much the Lightning have lost over the last few years in terms of talent as Petty lets it rip. No good. Lehman above 500 the last four seasons. In fact, the last time they finished under 500 was 2012-2013 season when they went 7-18. Only 2-14 in conference, thus not qualifying for the CUDIAC postseason tournament. As Collado and O'Neal Smith come in for Jerome Petty and Sean Epps. But you look at the success that Lehman has had recently, making at least the semifinal round in the CUNYAC tournament the last 4 years. Of course, falling to CCMY and then Baruch and then Brooklyn. Two of those 4 years losing to the eventual champion, obviously last year in the final round. Pulls to Collado. Bang. First three made for Collado. He's got 10. And the foul's going to go on Smith. That will lead to a timeout on the floor. Under 12 media timeout here at the Doghouse. A 69-36 lead for John Jay. Let's get to know the rifle teams. Eliza Kotoska.
Hi, my name is Eliza Kotoska. I am a junior and I'm on the John Jay rifle team. When I looked at the classes offered, a lot of them catered to a lot of my interests, that's why. Definitely the people, I didn't expect to meet the type of people that I meet here, so that's exciting to me. In 5 years, I see myself working for the city as well as pursuing a higher degree. Some of my best friends are definitely Mike and Ida. Definitely Mike. I would have to say Susanna.
.13 to go in the second half. It's been all John Jay. As they lead it by 33 over Lehman. As Feldman floats it into Strong. And the three gets knocked down by Feldman in the corner. It's O'Neal Smith, Santiago Collado, Doug Levy, Eric Pujols, as Strong misses the dunk. And Jordan Aiken on the floor for the Bloodhounds. And Feldman hits another three, and three better than two. One more point for Lehman. Pujols to turn around, gets the bucket. Eric Pujols was supposed to be the 11th man on John Jay's team, and well, when your quote-unquote 11th man is putting in the production that Pujols has put in, you're in good shape as Pujols now with 8 points, including two threes. Gathers with the takeaway. Feldman drawing in two. Strong, floater over. Levy doesn't go. And O'Neal Smith gets the board. And Steve Shulman not happy on the bench for Lehman. Not happy that his team isn't rebounding. And it'll be an offensive foul. Jordan Aiken draws the charge. And a line change for John Jay as LaGuardia, Epps, Petty, and Ford come in for Smith, Levy, Aiken, and Collado. Boy, Romello Ford can really get into the front court fast. Here's Jerome Petty. Epps in the corner. And they'll stay with John Jay, seven to shoot. Petty to the corner of Epps. Epps lets it fly. Short. Somebody was screaming, shoot it, shoot it. There have been plenty of time to shoot it. I'm not sure if it's a fan or somebody, but Epps hoisted that with 6 seconds to spare. And the foul's going to go on Petty. His third personal as Jermaine Wright will check in for the Bloodhounds after the first free throw. Strong 6 points in 12 minutes of action. And Strong, who had made all five of his free throws coming into today's contest, and has missed two today. Wright comes in for Petty. That one almost tipped back in, and Epps corrals the board. Right, thought about it, accelerating, nice find underneath. LaGuardia draws up two defenders. Second chance, LaGuardia draws the foul. Kyle LaGuardia, 6 points in 19 minutes of play. Hits the first one. Lehman now scoreless. In the last minute and 45 seconds as LaGuardia drills them both. Idrisu, no. Rebound right. Epps from the elbow, driving in through traffic. A Sean Epps can't be stopped. 14 points for E. Tommy Batista in the game for Lehman. Gathers over LaGuardia, gets it and one. Foul's going to go to LaGuardia. We'll have a timeout on the floor. 7:29 to go in the second half. It's been all John Jay on JohnJayAthletics.com.
in New York City. There is a place for people that want to be a part of something bigger than themselves. Where if you work hard, the possibilities are endless. A place to learn, train, and play. In that order. The City University of New York Athletic Conference. This is where it all comes together. Find your people, be a part of a team, and don't just play the game, change the game. Champions aren't born, they're built. The City University of New York. Be exceptional.
Kyle LaGuardia picked up his fourth foul before the whistle. And one shot for Isaiah Gethers. Gethers knocks it in. Jermaine Wright. It's fouled on the way up. Steve Shulman emptying the bench. On the floor, Will Feldman, Isaiah Gethers, Jaquan Strong, Sean Frederick, and Tommy Batista. Wright misses the first one. It's Wright, Ford, Epps, LaGuardia, and Pujols. And Aiken comes in for Ford. Feldman, the backdoor cut to Strong. And he gets hacked. One more for Strong. Epps up top as John Jay looks to pick up its first win of the conference season. And improve to 4-1. That would be the best start under Highland. As you get some collisions near midcourt. Frederick and Pujols and Epps all bump. As Ryan Highland. Very pleased with the effort of his team so far through the first five games. Aiken. And another foul on Lehman. As that's going to go on Gethers. All right, check that. They're going to put it on Frederick, so it'll be Frederick's first. Go, go, go. Right, accelerating inside. And he loses it. Here's Strong. Pop from behind by Frazier. It's a tie-up. Possession arrow pointing for John Jay. Aiken into Collado. Pujols, let's see if he's got another one in. I'm too strong. A heat check for Pujols. As we're under 6 minutes to go in the half. And Will Feldman, who's had himself a nice game. Pujols slips it to Aiken on the wing. 10 to shoot. Aiken facing up Feldman. Frees it up. Right, a three. No. Strong lets it fly. Too strong. Well, the question of what would happen when John Jay starts knocking down its shots. What type of team will they be? Well, the one good, strong thing about John Jay is that even though they're not going to shoot 60% from three every game, as much as they'd love to, the defense and the foundation for a good defensive team is there. And a real big test will be Tuesday evening when the Bloodhounds travel to Staten Island. And John Jay has had some good battles in Staten Island against the Dolphins. Remember, it's the Dolphins that usually come to the doghouse and have no problem eking out victories. But remember, a few years ago, too, when Frankie Schettino was on the team, that team that went perfect and beat CCNY in the final 2 seasons ago, John Jay had CSI on the ropes, and it was a tie game going into the final 2 minutes. Now, CSI ended up going perfect in conference play and winning the CUNYAC tournament, so you could throw out that silly argument of, oh, well, did going perfect have them going a little too strong? And did that affect them? But anyway, Highland calls a timeout. And we'll step aside, 76-53, John Jay leading Lehman. Well, Bloodhound fans, save the date. Homecoming will take place on Tuesday, December 11th, right here at the Doghouse. The women's team will face off against Sarah Lawrence at 5 p.m., followed by the men against Bard at 8 p.m. In between games, there will be an announcement to the John Jay College Hall of Fame Class of 2019. Also, we will introduce the current members of the Hall of Fame, and one lucky fan will have the opportunity to make a half-court shot for $10,000. That's $10,000. Here's Epps trying to drive baseline, whips it out to Petty, and Petty knocks down the three. Highland bringing his starters back in. He wasn't happy with the amount of fouls that the second team had been conceding. And with the game already out of reach, let's see how long Highland sticks with his starters to burn the clock. Leaving. And now Epps to Ford. Ford lets it fly, no, but a foul. Mo Idrissa and Jaquan Strong check in for Lehman. Ford hits the second. An 80 spot for John Jay. Second straight game. They've scored 80. Feldman, the shooter, draws in two. Gathers off the fingertips of Strong. Here's LaGuardia on the wing. Epps snaps a pass to Petty. John Jay just taking its time. Ford blocked underneath by Dennis Phillips, the freshman out of Manhattan. First foul on Phillips. This will be John Jay's basketball. As John Jay can take off 30 seconds at a time, and then Petty just throws it away. Now Ford in the corner steps out, and it'll stay with John Jay. Here's Ford. Now LaGuardia. Ford high arcing three off to the left. Ball tipped around. Levy puts it up. And Highland calls a timeout just to empty his bench. Keep it rolling. Defense! Feldman on the wing. Chris DeCintio checks in for the first time today. Madrisu off the mark. And O'Neal Smith grabs the rebound. Here's the entry pass. Strong will roll it in. He had missed a breakaway dunk earlier. DeCintio gets trapped. And Chris DeCintio, who has not scored this year, gets fouled and will have an opportunity to get on the board. After the game, we'll speak to Ryan Hyland and our player of the game. To get the final minute of play. Another turnover. Here's Gethers. And right into the front court. 8 second differential between the game and shot clock. As Collado slows it down to DeCintio. Well, it was all working for John Jay today. As the shot clock gets turned off. And Strong gets the bucket. Four Bloodhounds score in double figures. Jerome Petty leads the way with 18 points. Sean Epp scores 14 points of his own to go with 5 rebounds in 27 minutes. And he moves into second place all time on John Jay's scoring list as the Bloodhounds take care of the Lightning 83-65 to improve 2-4-1. Lehman Falls 2-2-3. We'll step aside. When we come back, we'll speak to head coach Ryan Hyland and our player of the game on johnjayathletics.com. Happy recap on a happy Saturday as it's a sweep for John Jay in the CUNYAC game of the week. The women win as well as the men. I'm joined by Ashawn Epps, Ryan Hyland. Ashawn, our player of the game, moving into second place on John Jay's all-time scoring list. I guess it seemed like only yesterday you were coming onto the campus here at John Jay. Just what's the journey been like?
It's been great. Just having the teammates with me. They've been pushing me every single day. I owe all this to my teammates and my coaches. I'm nothing without them. So this whole journey has been awesome with my teammates along with me.
What has been the difference between last year and this year now, too? Because it seems like you guys are playing with more of a swagger.
Yeah, it looks like we got a groove back almost. You know, it's like we're going hard now. Everybody's going hard. We're just working together. Everybody, the camaraderie is just really great right now. So we're just going to kind of try to keep it going.
Ryan, as a coach, how much does that energize you? Just knowing the fact that the guys are going to put in the work and basically whatever you say is gospel.
Yeah, guys follow their leaders. And E, along with Jordan and Doug and definitely some of the other guys, Jerome and Lucci, we got great leadership. And that makes the locker room great. It makes the off-the-court stuff great. And then that translates when you get on the court.
How about the fact that it seemed as if shooting was contagious? The question was, what's going to happen when you guys start to knock down your shots? You did so in throws today.
Yeah, it's about time, man. We weren't shooting very well coming into tonight. You know, we look at practice and we look at the stats and we look at these guys like Eric and like Jordan who are on our bench in San Diego. They're billed as shooters. You know, if they were on someone's scouting report, I wanted to say shooter. And they came in today and they did that. And they knocked down shots and that opens up things for him. And that opens up things for Mello and Doug. And every team in the country is better when the ball goes in. But you saw a little bit tonight what it looks like when we do it.
I'll have the last one for E. This is a team that knocked you off in the semifinals last year in the CUNY Athletic Conference Tournament. Does that add motivation? How much was that on your guys' mind?
With all due respect, we want to stomp on the next. We never forgot about that loss, so we want to translate that into this game today.
All right, well, that's a Sean Epps. That's Ryan Hyland. A happy recap as John Jay brushes aside Lehman right here at the Doghouse.